do? I can't just leave him out there. What if Sarah sees him? There's no way I can explain that. God, I need a drink. Jim, you bastard. You always knew this would happen.
All residents of the shady...
What a Christmas present you've given us this year.
How
will I ever explain what happened?
He has escaped. He has assaulted 3 hospital guards. He is alleged to be armed and dangerous.
Armed and dangerous?
The patient has an extensive history of assault. Use caution when dealing with him. The patient was last seen fleeing Meadowlark Hospital on foot at approximately 9 o'clock. His name is Chris Martin. He is 6'1" and weighs 175 pounds. Martin is said to be an avid follower of the Greater Good Cult.
All the insanity.
The GGC.
I was wrongly influenced by the media.
This year, the GGC was
involved. Yes, a cult has to be doing.
Leaving nearly 40 people
too
dead.
Too far-fetched. Who would believe it?
Members of the GGC believe in the universal good that prevails over all. These cult members venture out to right wrongs that have been committed. Again, Chris Martin is headed toward the Shady Glen area. Residents, lock your doors and beware.
I'll plead the fifth.
In our next
segment, how about self-defense?
Inside hospitals that house prisoners.
I swear, I had to do it.
Do these hospitals
there was no other way. Damn axe. Had to go and get stuck. Snow's really piling up out there. Maybe I can wait for the spring thaw before anyone notices he's out there.
With all things, you should do your best. If you
Jim,
are, there is
you weren't happy. Why didn't you tell me?
You should change the
a divorce would have been better than this.
Maybe you should look into the future.
No.
We can
I would rather run away than get a divorce. You always were so selfish. Even tonight. Tonight of all nights. Christmas Eve. Your last night, as it turns out. You couldn't even be happy staying with your own daughter, could you? Tammy.
Have you had a long day?
Need you ask?
Take a look around.
You can't go back out there.
Hot, steamy bubble bath.
It's snowing too hard.
Think of all the
even if I could drag him in, where would I put him? The basement? No. I'd have to drag him in through the house. See, Jim, if you'd clean the garage instead of going out with that girlfriend of yours, you'd be able to rot inside on Christmas.
Is there something that you should be doing right now?
Yeah, unfortunately, it's snowing too hard to do it right now.
Is procrastination a normal part of your routine?
Procrastination? Don't tell me about procrastination.
Organization can solve many of your problems.
He is the only father I've ever known with Christmas shopping on until Christmas Eve.
The use of a plan
he would rather be watching
the
game.
Idle time.
That was even obvious to Sarah.
Very easily change
it wasn't easy to explain to a 4-year-old why Daddy didn't want to spend time with her. His lying has turned me into a liar. Head hurts.
You need to get away from it all.
Get away from it all? Settle for a decent train.
It's what ails me.
Jim, you always were full of surprises.
Uses the Bahamas.
Remember when we built this house?
Don't sell yourself short.
You had everything made.
Don't settle for less.
Exactly as I wanted. That was years ago. Times have changed. You have changed. Who would have ever thought that this would be how it ended? Thank you. Merry Christmas to you, too. It's too bad that you can't celebrate Christmas dinner here tomorrow night. After your trip, you have to stop by and get your present. Well, thank you. Well, that was very nice of you. I'm sure Sarah will love anything you could give her. No, it's late. I'm tired. I couldn't ask you to come all the way out here. Denise, my house is a real pigsty. I know it's late, but my house is a real mess. I don't really want you driving alone out here at this hour. Okay, if it means that much to you, I'll see you soon. So,
the worst, May.
Looks like you'll be home for Christmas anyway.
An abrupt awakening from relaxation is the worst.
Where am I going to put it?
This is when you must find some sort of relief.
Oh, what if he stains the carpet?
Most pain medications don't come
from. I guess there's no time to think about anything else right now.
Take something that doesn't help.
Oh, Denise will
don't
be here
worry.
Soon.
Your preparation will be less
very
tedious
soon.
If you minimize the amount of work.
All right, I guess it's now or never.
When moving, you must know what your plan of attack is going to be before you begin. There's nothing worse than going to move. Having to redo things 10 times because you weren't prepared. We'll come out and take care of everything for you. Except, you have to do the preparation. Residents, there is a clear and present danger lurking in your neighborhood. Chris Martin is still headed towards the Shady Glen area. Please be prepared. New evidence has been discovered in the GGC case. If you remember last July, mass homicide left 39 people dead. Sadly, there was only one survivor. There has been new information that suggests government involvement. More to come on our 11 o'clock segment. The least expected culprits are usually the hardest to track. In the case of foul play, men are 10 times more likely to kill their spouses out of jealousy than women. This was found in a study conducted by the Meadowlawn Hospital. Of the 150 murderers that this hospital houses, less than 20 are women. Does this mean that less women commit murders? Or are women smarter about getting away with it? Take one look at this.
Well, Jim,
a different type of taste.
You gained weight. That last beer did not
so
simple
is good.
I almost couldn't get
with so many choices, how could you decide?
How would that have been?
Of course they all look alike.
What would Denise think?
After you taste this.
Oh, do I have to put you somewhere out of sight?
Imagine yourself flying through the air. You're going on that ski vacation you always dreamed of taking but never had time for. There you are.
Do you think you could fit in here?
Eating the peanuts.
I know you want to be comfortable, Jim. Remember,
she has a
brown. Can't be choosers.
She gives you half. Anxiously scarf it down. That's when you look down the aisle and notice that the stewardess is serving drinks in row 12.
If I move around enough boxes,
you're in row 480. Got milk?
Just a little bit further, Jim.
And they begin with a 1-2 punch. One man is down. One man is forced to stay up, hoping that the other will remain down. The first man is definitely out. But wait, there's someone else coming into the picture. Who is this? Boxing would be a very different sport if it were 2-on-1.
She drove too fast.
You don't realize how valuable the time they spent together.
He stays bright.
Unfortunately, sometimes you don't realize until it's too late. When you're looking at your own family, do you spend quality time together? Do you talk things?
I can always tell him to sort of, the whole house just has a different feel to it, believe me.
right, Jim. It's time for you to go into the closet. Okay?
Sometimes it's just nice to know that you have a good friend. Just to sit back, relax, and wait for Santa's arrival. The whole time you are struggling, it may come a moment when you just let go and move on. There will come a time when you can just relax and take some time to breathe. Tonight, that time is now. Good night, and have a wonderful Christmas Eve.
Then we got into that argument. What did you say, Jim? The television is too violent. The television sends us subliminal messages. The television influences everything we do. The television tells us what to do. Of course, that is what caused all of this. You're the one that caused all of this, whether you want to admit it or not. Too bad I didn't see it sooner. Maybe I could have prevented this. Maybe if I'd opened my eyes and done something, if only I suspected something. Oh, it's too late now. Okay. Now where is that gun? Maybe it's under here. All right, where would Jim have left it? Jim, where did you leave that gun? I don't believe this. You're the one that insisted on buying the gun. For protection, you said. A lot of protection it's providing you right now. I'm sure you would find all of this. Oh no. There's no way that you could. You idiot. Okay, it has to be in here. Please be in here. Come on, I have to reach this. Oh, Jim, why did you have to be so tall? Yes, it has to be in this box. Oh. Why did I learn how to use this? I guess now's as good a time as any. I need bullets. Jim, you did one thing right. Three bullets.
How's that?
Jim was a liar and was ruining our family.
the punishment does not fit his crime.
Why not?
Infidelity does not warrant death.
Does breaking a heart?
Your broken heart does not justify his death.
If not mine, then what about Sarah's?
She's not appear to be affected by his treatment.
But she is.
Still, that does not merit death.
Then what does?
Death.
Oh, so that is to be my punishment.
Yes.
And what is to happen to Sarah?
She will be taken care of.
By who?
You need not worry about that.
But I am her mother.
Not for much longer.
Give up. Have you guessed me yet?